Greetings and happy holidays from the Million Youth Chess Club. My name, Mike Reese, and I'm the president of the club, and I want to wish everyone a safe and happy holiday season and a very healthy and prosperous new year. It's now December 26th, the day after Christmas here in Reading, and special thanks to that anonymous friend of Berks Community Television for sponsoring this program. And because of that generous sponsorship, that generous donation, we're able to be on 6 times a year. And I want to thank that anonymous friend. I also certainly want to thank Berks Community Television, BCTV, for their tireless work on helping to produce and handle all the logistics of producing this show, and I want to thank you. I just love this habit. It is a little bit too much sometimes, so I'm going to put it off to the side. So this is our winter update. It's been a few months since I've personally been on. We like to mix it up with having an educational program where I spend the entire show teaching chess, but I think it's very important for us to update what we've been doing. This summer, 2019 was very successful for us. We were in the Ovid Boys and Girls Club again, the Reading Rec Commission again, and the Blacktop. We had summer chess in the park with a Blacktop Basketball League. So a very successful summer out at City Park and in the Ovid Boys and Girls Club and the Reading Rec Commission. You know, usually August, we take a little time off, and then this fall, we had some changes in our staff and some opportunities presented themselves. So I want to thank the United Way for their generous mini grant that continued throughout this year. 2019 was able to support our efforts at the Ovid Boys and Girls Club and some other areas, the Penn Street Farmers Market, the Reading Public Libraries, and a few other locations. It just gave us that little extra resources that we need to make a presence out in the community. And I just can't believe it, but next year, I've been here teaching chess, mentoring chess to the youth in Reading and Berks County since 2003. So I'm going to celebrate 17 years doing this, and I just love it. And just what a blessing it is for me. And I want to thank all the partners that we have, past, present, and of course, future partners. I want to thank you again. So in the fall, we were able to make a footprint in each of the library branches, the main and the three branches. So if we could have that first flyer, I want to let the public know, the viewing public know that we have free winter chess. So we had free fall chess. This will continue into the winter. So a big shout out to the director Bronwyn and each of the directors of those clubs at the site. So on Mondays, we're in the children's department at the main library. On Wednesdays, we're at Southeast Branch. On Thursdays, we're at Northwest Branch. And then again on Mondays, I want to have a big shout out for Dave. He's our instructor who handles all your chess needs at the Northeast Branch on Mondays. So you can see that. Thank you for the blow up there. So you can see that at the main library, 4 to 5 on Mondays. I'm there in the children's department on the second floor. The Northeast Branch is from 3:30 to 4:30 on Mondays. The Southeast Branch from 3:15 to 4:15 on Wednesdays, I'm there. And a big shout out to Miss Emily and Miss Allison out at Southeast. I'm there, and they are always so extraordinary helpful at the Southeast Branch of the library. We really have a great, thriving club there. We just had a little tournament there where we gave prizes out. We gave trophies out to a few people. So a big shout out to the Southeast Branch. The Northeast Branch, we have been there a full year. That's every Thursday. I'm there, 3:30s to 4:30s. These sites, we're really excited about these sites because they're always free and they're open to the entire public. Young and old, male or female, it doesn't matter your income, it's free for everyone. And chess is that great equalizer. It doesn't matter who you are, once you understand how to move the six different pieces, these are all math skills. Think before you move, you know, use your brain power, and it just doesn't matter who you are. So we're really excited, and we would love to have as many people as the fire marshal allows in these sites, because, you know, we just love doing it, and it's here. We particularly want the kids. They're designed to be after school programs. So sometimes, you know, like now we have a few days off because of the holidays, but the libraries generally have a very robust schedule in which they're open on most holidays. Of course, not the super holidays like Thanksgiving and Christmas and Labor Day, but they're open on most holidays. And so we make an effort to be there even on the holidays at the library. There are some gaps, of course, and weather, you know, does prevent us sometimes from getting there. But, you know, generally, year-round, we're at all four library locations. And I want to thank the library and the entire staff for your help. You know, our annual Martin Luther King chess event will be held once again the Friday before the federal holiday. And this year, it's Friday, January 17th. Now, we'll continue to be back at 11th and Pike Rec Center. Again, free and open to the public. We'll start at 5:30. This is a nice opportunity for kids who know how to play chess to compete for trophies. And if you don't know how to play chess, come out and learn. Great opportunity. But we have these events. We certainly want to encourage kids who already know how to play chess to compete for trophies. And when we have trophies, we have the best of, you know, single elimination type format. We have the best person out of that group. And we usually set up two different puzzles. Now, I've gotten a few extra different books this year. I'm not quite sure which book I'm going to use. I tend to use the same book, so some of these puzzles may be familiar because we use that as part of our training and a part of our mentorship. You know, people think differently. People respond differently. Sometimes people do very well head-to-head, one-on-one competitions. Not everyone does very well that way. You know, they get nervous, they move too quickly. But a puzzle is very static. It's set up, do not touch the pieces, and you need to think of the winning move. Now, a little more advanced a puzzle will have two moves. But most puzzles will have one winning move. You get that right, you're in the running for a prize. So I want to invite everyone to 11th and Pike Rec Center, again, free, open to the public. This is designed for youth. Certainly, we want to see adults bring their kids there. And we are always looking for volunteers. And at the end of the program, my contact information will be put up on your TV screen. So we want to encourage any volunteers you're thinking about, you want to get a little bit more involved in chess. So, you know, we can have a lot of opportunities. We have a few open spots right now. We need to say goodbye and best wishes to a couple instructors. And in 2019, I want to say goodbye and best wishes to Mr. Sean. Sean has done very well at several sites, and he recently got his master's degree and has moved out to the Carlisle area, the other side of Harrisburg. He had an excellent job opportunity, and I want to say best wishes to Mr. Sean. I want to thank you for your support of the past years with the Million Youth Chess Club. You've been a real asset, and we're going to miss you, and certainly we appreciate everything you've done and wish you best in your career. You know, I want to say The best wishes and good luck to Miss Tina. She had some challenges in her family, and she has at least at this time relocated to the Sunshine State of Florida. So it's hard to compete with nice warm weather in the 70s, 80s, and 90s when it's 30 here today. Well, it's actually about 45 right now, so it's pretty nice right now, but it was 20 a few weeks ago. So, you know, I want to give a shout out to Miss Tina, our former secretary treasurer. You know, you did a heck of a job, and I know that you still support us on our Facebook, but we certainly would like to have some local youth step up and guide an old guy like me on our Facebook presence. We have room for growth there on Facebook, and because of the leadership of Tina, we do have a Facebook presence, and we certainly appreciate your support, and we'll always miss you. And if you decide to come back to the Commonwealth of Pennsylvania, we'll hopefully still be here, and we are always in need of instructors one way or another. We're at a good growing point here. We have a few opportunities that at this point we cannot fill because we don't have those instructors. So we're good right now for the moment, but we have some opportunities coming up. And one more final farewell and best wishes is Mr. Bud. Mr. Bud has been a longtime supporter. I met him years ago. He came to the Martin Luther King event in January and has been helpful on several sites, including the Maine Public Library and the Blacktop and a few other sites in the summer. And Bud, I know you had some health challenges, and you know, get well soon, and just take care of yourself during this season of your life. You and your wife, Becky, you've been great supporters. Thanks for the Christmas card. We really appreciate all your efforts, and I want to thank you again on TV here, because you know, it's because of the people that have supported us in the past, we continue to be successful today, and I need to thank those folks. We do have a few more opportunities. Mr. Roberto from the YMCA, I was talking to him today. Last year, well, you know, 2019, last winter, we had Sunday chess at the YMCA. And we're going to do that again. We don't have the date yet, but when it's nice and cold out there, we tend to be indoors. So the YMCA has several floors of residence, of housing there, transitional housing, and we have some adult chess players there. And on Sundays, we certainly have youth playing basketball and coming into the Y. So Roberto has allowed us to use the front room before you enter the Y. So this would be another free and open chess opportunity for young and old alike. So those dates will be announced. And last year we had it March, April, and May. So I think we'll probably start this in February, March, and April when it's a little colder. May, sometimes it gets a little bit too nice out there. People want to run outside. So we certainly understand that. Also, another opportunity will be the RISE Center. This is a Council of Chemical Abuse Center. It just opened in September. It's at the 8th and Ole Big Mill Outlet Building. You access it from the Nichols Street side. This is designed for those folks in recovery. Information and support. They're open Monday through Saturday, and we're going to have chess a couple times in January there. Now, I'll personally be there on January 18th and January 25th. Those are two Saturdays in this coming January at the RISE Center. And I want to thank particularly Yvonne Stroman, who has a TV show here on BCTV from the Council of Chemical Abuse. She's the director and the contact coordinator from the council for the RISE Center, and she's doing a heck of a job filling spots with volunteers of different types of programs, 12-step meetings, arts and crafts, yoga, and the like. I understand budget counseling is on board. There's a few other programs. So the Council of Chemical Abuse, if you check their website, they have all that information, and they They, of course, have a Facebook page, and they'll update these events. So want to look forward to the YMCA, chess on Sundays this winter, and also at the Rise Center. And I want to thank, again, all our partners, particularly Miss Kat. Kat, thank you very much for securing some new funding at the Olivet Boys and Girls Club. We've had a long time relationship with the Olivets, probably 15 years. I mean, just shortly after I showed up, we partnered with the Olivet Boys and Girls Club. And as we know, in business, there's sometimes financial ups and downs. And we were able to secure some funding for 2020. And that was through the leadership of the new CEO, Chris. Thank you, Chris. And welcome aboard to the Olivet Boys and Girls Club. And Kat, you're the coordinator of this grant, and so we greatly appreciate it. So we'll continue the program at the Olivet Boys and Girls Club Tuesday. Now, these are for members of the Olivet, so I want to talk so highly of the Olivets because they're about good, wholesome, after-school activities for young people. They particularly want them to use their minds and stay off of drugs and gangs and all those negative behaviors, and they want to make sure young people graduate from high school, and if they're able and willing, continue their education after high school. And those young members of the Olivet Boys and Girls Club, head and shoulders above the general population, a high rate of high school graduation and a high rate of acceptance in college for those who apply. So we think chess is a very important part of that because chess or math skills, cognitive reasoning, critical thinking, those type of things would serve people well to help them focus on the task right at hand. So we'll be back at Clinton Street on Tuesdays, the PAL on Wednesdays, Glenside on Thursdays, and Friday's going to be a busy day for us. We'll be at Oak Brook, we'll be at 4th and Windsor, and Shillington, and Pandora on Friday. So we're going to mix it up on Fridays, but that seems to be a very popular day for chess club at those sites. So we're looking forward to continuing the relationship with the Olivet Boys and Girls Club. The Reading Rec Commission has done a fine job with their rec programs. Their club directors are handling those programs individually. And next month, we'll be back at 11th and Pike with the Martin Luther King event. So I understand they got some pretty good players up there because under the direction of Mr. Austin there, he's taking care of business up there. So we'll have some kids, hopefully, from 3rd Spruce Rec Center and from 11th and Pike Rec Center. And these events are open to the public, these special chess events, so that Martin Luther King event is open to anyone. And so we'll be talking to all the youth at the libraries, particularly, to come up, and we'll be talking to the youth at the Olivet Boys and Girls Club, and invite all of them. So we want to invite this as a public invitation for that event also. Just briefly, I know I only have a few minutes, but I always like to, since I have this chessboard, we only have 6 different pieces. And for those out there in the viewing audience are wondering, like, man, I wish I knew how to play chess. So there's a lot of opportunities online and books, but I could just tell you real briefly, there's only 6 different pieces. All the pieces in the back row, all of them, move forward and backward. The pawns, the pieces in the front, the foot soldiers, only move forward. The rook moves in a very simple straight line up and down the row, or a very simple straight line across the row. There's only one piece that jumps, that it looks like a horse. It's called a knight. It always moves 4 squares total, from a white square to a black square, or from a black square to a white square, and it always moves like an L. It's the only piece that jumps. This board is a chess board. It's the exact size as a checkerboard. The big difference is in chess, we use every square. In checkers, you only use the dark squares. Also in chess, no matter what, you can only take one piece at a time. And in checkers, you can take more than one if it's available. The bishop, you have one on a black square, one on a white square. It always stays on that same color square. It always moves in a diagonal and a slant. The queen, the most powerful piece on the board, moves like a rook or a bishop. It's your choice. Straight up and down the row, across the row, or the same color. So it moves either or. It's a straight line, so it's not and, not a rook and a bishop. It's either or. So it's very simple straight lines. And when I try to explain, well, why is this, these are masculines. There's several ways that these are very easily masculines. Well, first of all, the sorting is a math skill, and you have six different pieces. They move six different ways, so that's a sorting. And also, the straight lines you'll see often in construction. When you look in a room, I'm looking in this room here. We have straight lines in the doors and the ceilings, the floors. The knight moves in a 45 degree angle. You see most doors come to a 45 degree angle, most windows 45 degree angles, ceiling tile, floor tile 45 degree angles. You look in electrical and plumbing fixtures, often those angles apply also. These pieces, unlike checkers the pieces are equal, but in chess they're weighted. So the bigger pieces here are worth more. And we assign a point value, and the point value is based on the number of squares a piece can move in an open board. So when there's nothing on the board and you put the piece there, they figure out how many squares they can move. So a pawn is worth one, and I always tell the kids, hey, you know what money looks like? Oh yeah. All right, so that's $1. The bishop and the knight are equal, $3. Now some books say that the bishop has a slight advantage, but I just make it easy and just call both of them $3. The rook is $5. The queen, the most valuable piece, is $9. I say the king is the game. The king, which only moves one square anywhere, and the whole idea of chess is to trap the king. The king never leaves the board. You cannot take the king. The king can never put itself in danger. The whole idea is to stay out of danger and to trap the enemy king. The king's worth a bazillion points. But in a defense, it's worth about three. But you can't take it. So you can't take a king for a bishop. On the back of our business card, the Million Youth Chess Club, and this comes right out of the golden rules of chess. For those folks who play chess, and I often get people, yeah, let's play a game of chess, and I usually just like to play a game and kind of see where they're at. And if I could offer some suggestions, I ask them if they're open to suggestions. And the five tips that I talk about with chess are: one, getting control of the center of the board. These are two armies. Chess is a very old game of war. So whatever army controls the center can strike the opponent from the left or the right flank. The army that controls the center can prevent the enemy army from getting around and striking your army. So it's very powerful to focus on the center. And in life, it's very powerful to focus on the most important thing in your life. Every day you wake up, you focus on what's the most important thing. You use all your resources, you get your knights and bishops out quickly, you castle, you protect your king, that's a special move. You always be mindful of your surroundings. You're always looking at your opponent's last move. And the one thing that has always helped me in life is take your time. Before you move, You think before you move. The consequences are real in life. Take your time before you make decisions, particularly major decisions. Take your time. Sleep on it. So I want to wish everybody in the viewing audience happy holidays. This is Mike Reese, the Million Youth Chess Club. I want to thank again all our partners, our special anonymous friend who sponsors this program, the Olivet Boys and Girls Club, our juvenile probation site that we have, the Reading Public Libraries. We have two more events. We have one more event coming up and the Reading Public Library. We have free chess. That's a new, we have all four. If we can have my contact information up before we leave, I want to thank everyone and wish everyone a happy holiday season and a happy and healthy and prosperous 2020, a new year. Happy holidays from the Million Youth Chess Club. Thank you.